The last decade of Nigerian history has witnessed an increase in violent conflicts and criminality that have been strongly characterized by religious sentiments. Religiously motivated violence has been especially common in Kaduna State, which is located in the heart of northern Nigeria. Plan International Nigeria, in the last 1 year, implemented a Kaduna State Youth Peace Building Academy YPA project in partnership with the Kuka Center.
For us in Plan International, conflict has been a major distraction. Particularly violent conflict, there are distractions that strongly deepens poverty, excludes women, undermines the growth of children, and retards the development of girls. And as an agency, these are key people, key constituencies that we are very concerned with. So when we intervene on issues around conflict and try to manage conflicts and build community or communal harmony, we are responding because we recognized the significant implications that it has on the development of people.
KSYPE has really changed me in person, because before the coming of Plan International selecting us to go for the training, I had this concept that every Christian is an enemy. It was after the training, though, I went further to make research in the scripture, showing me that the Muslim and the Christian are coming from one source. So we see no reason why we shouldn't tolerate each other as Muslims or Christians. The KSYPA has changed me in person, because now my best friend is a Christian.
Gaskiya zuwan da Plan International sun zo ya canza mana rayuwa, ya kuma kara mana zaman lafiya a al'umman mu. Domin lokacin kamun su zo, gaskiya akwai rigingimu da yawa da aka yi, amma da abun ya haifar ma da ya sa ma ba mu iya shiga inda akwai Hausawa. Hausawa kuma ba za su iya su zo inda mu Christian muke ba. Amma zuwa Plan International ya sa har yanzu ni karan kaina ni ina iya in shiga dangoma, in shiga gidaje, in zona har in ci abinci da su. Amma before da rigima din nan ta taso, gaskiya ba mu yin haka. Ko ni ma na dinga avoiding nasu, bana ma so abin da zai hada ni da su. Amma tun da Plan suka zo suka hada mu, muka je training din nan tare, sai mun gane cewa ya kamata mu zauna tare, domin ni ina bukatan su a rayuwa, su kuma suna bukata na mu yi tafiya tare.
We do know for a fact that Kaduna State has a huge youth population. 54% of its 6.1 million people are actually in the youth bracket. They are all over. And the major drivers of conflict that we see based on our analysis, sometimes the youth category falls within this bracket, whether you want to talk about youth unemployment, underemployment, lack of empowerment, and the other factors that normally interplay to create conflict, drug abuse, substance abuse, and all of that. And youth themselves being sometimes very good stakeholders when it comes to peace building, but also sometimes themselves being perpetrators of conflict. So that entry point was perfect. And I believe that having worked with the youth for as long as you have, we have been able to develop a pool of youth who will serve as influencers, who will serve as peace ambassadors in the communities where they work. And this has inched us closer to our own priorities as a peace commission.
For us, it's an incredible opportunity to partner with a very giant and elephant-like organization like, you know, the Plan International. One of our key program areas at the Kuka Center is leadership training for young people. And so the partnership actually fits in very comfortably, you know, with that particular program area. So we have learned quite a lot, quite a lot as an organization. Number one, it has given us the platform to fulfill that particular program area in training young people.
I'm happy to be engaged in this project. I'm happy to have led the process over the course of 1 year. What we are hoping and believing is that the youth are going to come up with a sustainability plan for this project. If plan is able to provide the funds to continue, fine and good. Otherwise, the skills we've been able to impart in these young people, we believe the platforms that have emerged in the course of implementation are going to sustain peace efforts in Kaduna State.
Dangoma community was identified in Jama'a local government area. The reason for the choice of Dangoma for this project is because it has been the bellwether that determines violence not only in Guska Bakinkoyi, but in most places in Jama'a local government area and beyond. Kasua Magani in recent times has almost become synonymous with violent conflicts. The Kajuru local government area community has in recent times had ethno-religious conflicts that claimed lives and properties, and in adjoining communities. The violent conflicts, which date as far back as 1980, has remained one of the most irretractable in the state and in the country.
Gaske Plan International Kuka Santa ta canza garin nan sosai ta wurin yanda aka zakulo matasa goma ta bangaren musulmi goma ta bangaren krista da gaske an samu canji sosai sosai domin da can da wannan hargitsin da ya faru bayan da za a ce musulmi ya shiga unguwan krista ko kuma krista ya shiga cikin unguwan musulmi to amma yanzu wannan plan kuka international ta taimaka ana cudanya a wuri daya
da wansu daga wannan horoso da ka samu daga kuka center da plan international ya nuna mana lalle an horo da su yanda ya kamata sannan kuma mun ji dadi domin ta wurin su yau akwai ababa daban-daban wanda su ma da suka dawo sun nuna ma soran jama'an gari ba matasa kawai ba har da wadansu dattawan ma sun nuna musu muhimmancin zaman lafiya sun nuna musu illan yada jita-jita sun nuna musu illan rashin zaman lafiya sun nuna musu me yasa ma zaman lafiya ke da muhimmanci domin yau sai kaga ta wurin wannan matasan mu guda 20 za ka ga yanda ake cudanya tsakanin krista da musulmai.
Zaria Metropolis has its fair history of conflicts. However, Sabongari is particularly notorious with conflicts and violence. If there is, therefore, any location that needs being prioritized for peacekeeping efforts, Sabongari community in Sabongari local government area fits in quite well.
My being a member of KSYPA, Sabongari Zaria Cohort, has been awesome because so far it has helped in shaping me personally and then helping me make impact in my community. Before now, my view and perception about peace building has been different. But then after some couple of engagements and trainings we've had as a cohort, I have been better enlightened about what peace building actually is. And then with that, I've been able to provide some intervention within my host community.
Tunda wayannan yara suka taho aka zakulo su daga ko wace wato shiya a cikin fadin karamin hukumar Sabon Gari da Zaria wayannan yara sun yi wayansu abubuwa guda uku ko hudu farko wato sun yi kokari domin su hada wani irin wasa na kwallo wanda suka hada kan samari musulmi da krista domin in ka gansu suna ma aikin su kai ba za ka gane cewa a'a wannan musulmi ne wannan krista ne ko kuma wannan krista ne wannan musulmi bane a'a gaba ɗaya suke haɗuwa suke yi.
Before the elections they were able to do a kind of discussion with the contenders, those that were contesting for elections. They met with them, organized a meeting, discussed with them and made them sign some peace agreement so that there will be peace during the election period. And that was done successfully. Recently, there was also a project they embarked upon on the girl child. And if you know that in this part of the world, particularly in northern Nigeria, the place of the girl child has always been relegated to the background, particularly in terms of education. So that was also another opportunity to enlighten the community about the need for the girl child education.
Birnin Gwari is multicultural and religious community that is known for youth restiveness and violence. Making it one of the priorities of the project was therefore comprehensible.
It has improved tremendously and positively to the life of the youth and the general public of Birnin Gwari. Let me cite this using where I work as an instance. In the past, when you arrest an offender for a traffic offense and you bring his bike, for instance, to the office, what follows after is sometimes violent. They want their bike at all costs. But for quite some time now, we've not experienced that, which I will say could be an attribute of the teachings of the series of the programs you've been holding here in Birnin Gwari, which has impacted positively and changed the mindset of youths towards violence in general.
Seriously, Plan International has, in fact, it is a savior to Birnin Gwari in particular, because it has saved us from so many things that were about to happen, because their coming was even timely, seriously. They came during the election time whereby things were calm. Nobody expected that we would have such peace during elections in Birnin Gwari.
Rigasa community is located in Igabi local government area in the central senatorial district of Kaduna State. The community, which has over 1 million inhabitants, has only one electoral ward and has been neglected by government. This partly explains why it has been a cockpit of violence, which is being perpetrated by youth gangs of the area. From its brief characteristics, the community suits the objective of KPA and is thus considered.
Plan International have make us to manage our anger, to be a good mediator, and even breaking telephones, because some of the rumors is the one that used to bring conflict to our community. But we now know the importance and the effect of that. The Rigasa as whole have now know that, okay, when we stay at with each other, it is very, very important, because they need me and we need them. So for you to stay alone, at least if you kill everybody, who are you going to stay with? Nobody.
The conflict transformation roles of these young people include working to ensure their communities hitherto torn apart by internal conflicts to places where young leaders would meet, irrespective of ethnic, religious and social backgrounds, to exchange ideas.
Oftentimes before now, when you talk about peace building, women and girls are the last people that set of people that anybody would think about in the community. But in recent times, the paradigm has shifted, where people begin to see the importance of having the views of girls and women in peace building. And recent activities have also shown that the role that they play is very critical in ensuring, especially for the young girls, you get their views, and then for the women, they are closer to the young boys that oftentimes are seen to be the perpetrators of conflict that leads to violence. So it's a very important role in peace building, and if we need to do anything and have a high impact, we would need to deepen that engagement of young girls and women in when we talk about peace building.
Over 8,500 indirect beneficiaries and 100 direct beneficiaries, greater percentage of female beneficiaries than male counterpart.
International Anguka Center has brought us new ways to better our lives. Plan International Anguka Center has brought us new ways to better our lives.